5 herbs and supplements for type 2 diabetes. Diabetes is a lifelong condition that affects the blood sugar and insulin levels in the body. Treatment includes lifestyle strategies and sometimes medication, but some complementary therapies, such as herbs and supplements, may help. In diabetes, the body either does not produce enough insulin or produces insulin that the body does not use properly. Herbs and supplements will not cure diabetes and do not constitute a standalone treatment. But some may combine with conventional treatment to provide relief from symptoms and reduce the risk of complications. 5 herbs and supplements. Here are 5 herbs and supplements that may be of benefit to people with type 2 diabetes. 1. Aloe vera. Aloe vera is a common plant with many different uses. Many people are aware of its benefits for skin care, but it may also have other benefits, including slowing the progress of type 2 diabetes. One review, published in 2013, looked at the use of aloe vera to treat symptoms of diabetes in rats. Findings suggested that aloe vera might help protect and repair the beta cells in the pancreas that produce insulin. The researchers believed this might be due to aloe's antioxidant effects. The researchers called for more research into aloe and its extracts to be sure of these effects. Ways of taking aloe include adding juice pulp to a drink or smoothie, taking capsules that contain aloe as supplements. People should not eat aloe vera skincare products. Aloe vera juice may offer a number of health benefits. 2. Cinnamon. Cinnamon is a fragrant spice that comes from the bark of a tree. It is a popular ingredient in sweets, baked goods, and other dishes. It has a taste that can add sweetness without any additional sugar. It is popular with people with type 2 diabetes for this reason alone, but it may also offer other benefits. A 2010 review found evidence from studies involving humans that cinnamon may improve levels of glucose, insulin and insulin sensitivity lipids, or fats, in the blood, antioxidant status, blood pressure, lean body mass, digestion. People can take cinnamon in a variety of cooked dishes and baked goods, in teas, as a supplement. Anyone who is thinking of using cinnamon supplements should speak to their doctor first. 3. Bitter melon. Mammordica charantia, or bitter melon, is a medicinal fruit. Practitioners of traditional Chinese and Indian medicine have used bitter melon for centuries. People can cook the fruit and use it in many dishes. Some scientists have been looking into its potential medicinal uses. There is some evidence that bitter melon may help with the symptoms of diabetes. One review has noted that people have used many parts of the plant to help treat diabetes. Research has shown that taking bitter melon in the following forms can lead to a reduction in blood sugar levels in some people. Seeds, blended vegetable pulp, juice, supplements. Eating or drinking the bitter melon can be an acquired taste, but taking supplements may make it more palatable. There is not enough evidence to support using bitter melon instead of insulin or medication for diabetes. However, it may help people rely less on those medications or lower their dosages. 4. Gymnema. Gymnema sylvester is a herb that comes from India. Its name means sugar destroyer. A 2013 review noted that people with both type 1 and type 2 diabetes who took gymnema showed signs of improvement. In people with type 1 diabetes who took the leaf extract for 18 months, fasting blood sugar levels fell significantly, compared with a group who received only insulin. Other tests using gymnema found that people with type 2 diabetes responded well to both the leaf and its extract over various periods. Some people experienced lower blood sugar levels, higher insulin levels. Using either the ground leaf or leaf extract may be beneficial. But once again, talk to your doctor about using it before starting. 5. Ginger. Ginger is another herb that people have used for thousands of years in traditional medicine systems. People often use ginger to help treat digestive and inflammatory issues. However, in 2015, a review suggested that it may also help treat diabetes. The results showed that ginger lowered blood sugar levels, but did not lower blood insulin levels. Because of this, they suggest that ginger may reduce insulin resistance in the body for type 2 diabetes. However, the researchers were uncertain as to how ginger might do this, and they called for more research to confirm these findings. People can take ginger. By adding ginger powder or chopped, fresh ginger root to raw or cooked food brewed into tea as a supplement in capsule form by drinking it in a ginger ale. Considerations for people for diabetes. People should always work with a healthcare professional before taking any new herb or supplement. The doctor may suggest starting with a lower dose and gradually increasing it until the person finds a suitable dose. Some herbs can interact with other medications that do the same job, such as blood thinners and high blood pressure medications. It is essential to be aware of any interactions before starting a new supplement. People should also ensure they obtain their herbs and supplements from a high-quality source. The Food and Drug Administration, FDA, do not monitor herbs and supplements, so products may contain different herbs and fillers, recommend an incorrect dose, or be contaminated, for example, with pesticides. Herbs and supplements are a complementary treatment option, and should not replace medications. Discover recommended programs on the description below. Click below for more information now.